What do you do with an old balloon you got for Valentine's Day?
Today I'm going to show you some awesome effects with lighting. Hey guys, welcome to Phlearn. My name is Aaron Nace. You can find me on Twitter at AKNacer. Today we're doing some really exciting things in Photoshop.
I'm going to show you guys how to take some really cool images with a lighting effect and actually create like a halo and some really cool things based on an image that you guys provided us in a contest. So I can't wait to get into it. Today's gonna be an awesome episode. Let's go ahead and get started. All right, let's get started, guys. This is our image. It was submitted by EJ for a contest, and EJ, you won a Phlearn Pro because we're editing your image here on Phlearn. This is what we're gonna be doing today. A very cool lighting effect, making this person into like a queen of the forest. And not only are we creating like a kind of crown of light and glow around it, but we're doing some really great things to lighten up their dress as well. So let's go ahead and turn that off, and I'm gonna show you guys how to do it from scratch. Basically, we got the idea. It was a really just amazing image, and I thought it might be cool to kind of play with light for the image. So what we're gonna do is I'm gonna create a new layer right above our background here. And the first thing I wanna do is create our little crown. So it's really not that hard to create. What we're gonna do is I'm gonna grab my polygonal lasso tool, and I'm gonna create kind of like a triangle shape up here. And you can create this, you know, in basically whatever shape you want. We're just gonna stick with something like this. Okay, so we've got our triangle shape there, and now you're thinking like, okay, do I gotta like make a million of these and kind of array them and things like that? Well, you don't, because there's a really cool thing in Photoshop called step and repeat that's just gonna do it for you. So what we're gonna do now is I'm gonna hold shift delete, and we're just gonna fill this with, let's just say fill that with white. There we go. And let's go ahead and just put this maybe, yeah, just right there off to the left. That looks pretty good. Now, what I wanna do is be able to copy this over and over again and kind of scale it as I do it. So keep, pay attention to the next few keyboard commands because they're relatively important. Okay, first thing we're gonna do is hit Control or Command and click on our thumbnail. And that's gonna turn your layer into a selection. Okay, so that's a really important step. The next is we're gonna hold down Option Command or Alt Control if you guys are on a PC, and then I'm gonna hit T. So Option Command is the step part of our transformation. And what we're gonna do is I'm gonna move our little point right here. You can move your pivot point. If you're going over it and it won't allow you to move it, you can also move it using these guys right over here. So let's move it to the very bottom here. And then if I hover over it, I should be able to move it again. Okay, there we go. So it's allowing me to move my little pivot point there. And now what that means is when I rotate it, it's gonna rotate it around that point instead of around the middle. So I'm gonna hold the shift key and, there we go. Sorry, you don't actually need to hold the shift key. We're just gonna rotate this a little bit to the left there. So we've got and you can see it's copying it. Because when you do a transform, when something's selected like it is there, it's going to copy it over, that's what's called the step, and it's gonna be on the same layer. So I'm gonna now hold the shift and the option key, this is shift and alt if you guys are on a PC, and make it a little bit smaller. Okay, there we go, that's our transformation, and then I'm gonna hit this checkbox up here, and it's going to apply it. So what we have now is our main shape, and we've just kind of transformed it and scaled it over a little bit. So that's our step part of the step and repeat. Now comes the repeat part, and this is where it gets really cool. It's actually really easy to do. Now just hold the shift, option, and command. If you guys are on a PC, it's gonna be shift, alt, and control, and then hit T a couple of times. So those three down and hit T. And each time you do, it's going to apply that same exact transformation that you just did over and over and over and over again. And you can just see hitting T a bunch of times. Now we've got that really cool shape. So really not that hard. We've made that cool kind of crown thing and just a couple of steps. So we've got half of a crown now, well, like a fourth of it. What do we do to get a little bit more? I'm gonna hit Command J, and then Command J duplicates your layer. Command T, right click, and then flip horizontal. Okay, so now we've got something like this. And maybe we'll just go ahead and bring that in there. And you can do this basically any way you decide to make your crown or whatever you're gonna make lighting effect using the step and repeat. It's gonna come out differently every time you do it because those transformations are, you know, they're just gonna look a little bit different. So we'll make this one, and if we like it, we'll stick with it. And if we don't, you can make a different one. But every single time you're gonna do this, they're gonna come out a little bit different. So I've got that shape, I think it's really cool, and now I'm just gonna copy it over. So I'm gonna hit Command J, I went ahead and grouped those two layers. So they're in a group now. I'm gonna hit Command J on the group, and then we're just gonna transform this. So I'm gonna like kind of bring it out, and then holding down Shift and Alt or Option, I'm going to stretch those out as well. So what we've got now is basically the crown, and it's in two different shapes here. It's in the shape of, you know, the top part of the crown and then the bottom. And I can kind of drag this down, kind of move it however we want. But I think that looks pretty good so far. So this is gonna be our crown that's on the top of our subject. Maybe I think it could go a little bit bigger. So let's shift click the two of those, and I'm gonna hit Command T, which is gonna bring up our transform, grab our midpoint here, and then just kind of scale that out a little bit there. Okay, so now we've got a point that's quite a bit bigger. So what are we gonna do with it now? Well, we need to apply this into a curves adjustment layer. So instead of just showing up white, it's actually gonna look like it's going to brighten up that area. So we'll show you how to do that now. So how do we transfer what we've already created onto a curves adjustment layer? All we need to do is we've got those two layers. I'm gonna hit Command E, and that's gonna merge them together. Sorry, they're two groups. So we've got those together now. Now we're gonna hold down Control or Command, and I'm gonna click on this shape, and that's gonna turn that into a selection. So you can see, now that we have a selection, it's probably gonna be pretty easy to apply that into a curves adjustment layer. All you need to do is grab an adjustment layer. We're gonna go down to curves. And what it's gonna do is it's gonna automatically load that selection as a layer mask. So if you have a selection already active and you grab an adjustment layer, it's gonna load that selection as a layer mask. Okay, so it's gonna be visible there. Let's just grab our curves adjustment layer, and I'm gonna really just crank that quite a bit brighter. And then we have our really cool lighting effect just like that. So we can see it really doesn't, you know, take a whole long time to get something like this. Now, because I wanted to create, I like creating things in a bunch of different layers. It tends to make things look a little bit more real and, you know, just give it a little bit more effect. I mean, we're creating a light crown. It's not exactly gonna look real no matter what you do, but it's gonna look a little bit more like a cool effect. So I'm gonna hit Command J to duplicate that again. And now we're just gonna give this a blur. So here on the layer mask, we're gonna go to Filter, Blur, and then down to Gaussian Blur. Okay, and something like that, you can just kind of decide for yourself whatever's gonna look a little bit best. But this is just gonna give it a little bit of, you know, keep it from being one-dimensional, just kind of adds a little bit more to the entire blur. And you can change your opacity and kind of play around there as much as you want. All right, very cool. Now keep in mind, this has nothing to do with our subject. So if I wanted to, let's go ahead and group those out. Maybe I wanna make them, you know, just a little bit bigger, and kind of bring it down. There we go, that looks pretty cool. Now I can put a layer mask on that entire group, and this is where I can kind of define, you know, where I want this to be invisible and where I want it to be visible. So I'm gonna stay away from, I'm not gonna try to do a perfect job cutting out all these things that are already there. If you wanted to, be my guest. You can, you know, cut things out, but oftentimes I find, especially with light, it's a little bit better to blend. And because we do already have, you know, this nice light face, it's it should allow us to blend relatively well. So that's what I'm gonna stick to. But of course, when you guys are working on your images, you can do whatever you want. All right, there we go. Cool, so we're just sticking to blending, and that it just makes my job quite a bit easier. Now we're gonna do a little bit more with this. I'm gonna grab a new layer. We're gonna bring this under, actually, the layer we were just painting on. And I'm just gonna grab a gradient tool, G for the gradient tool. Let's grab a nice light color that's kind of here in, I don't wanna grab white, maybe it's just something that's like right there in the crown. And then we're gonna use our radial gradient, click on our gradient editor, and make sure you're using the foreground as transparent. And then click right here in the middle and kind of drag out. It's just gonna kind of create that nice little halo again. Okay, now we don't want this to darken anything, it's supposed to be light. So we're gonna go from normal down here to lighten. It's gonna make sure we're not darkening like the side of the face and things like that. Let's put a layer mask on this, and then you can kind of paint away wherever you want to as well. You know, make it a little bit less. Generally when things look like, you know, perfect circles and things like that in Photoshop, it just kind of looks like you did them in Photoshop. So I try to, you know, put a kind of layer mask and just paint around with some weird shapes on there. It's gonna break it up. You can see here's the before, just kind of looks like a, you know, circle that was made in Photoshop. This looks just a little bit more natural. I know we're making a crazy light crown on a queen of the forest, so nothing about this image is natural, but it doesn't look as Photoshoppy. Okay, now let's go ahead and bring this in. I wanna bring some of this lighting effect that I really like onto not only the top here, so it looks kind of like it's actually affecting the rest of our subject, but even on down to our dress area. So we're going to do that by grabbing another curves adjustment layer. Let's go to our adjustment layers and go up here to curves, and then we're going to click and just really drag that up. All right, looking good. Let's go ahead and bring that up to the very top, and then I'm going to hit Command I on that, and we're going to paint white here on our subject, just right up here. And I'm actually going to do this over two different layers, and I'm going to show you guys why in just a second. I'm going to try to like kind of imitate some of the light fall off from the crown here. Okay, so I'm going to take care of the top part, and then I'm going to take care of the bottom part of her dress completely differently. The same, just a little bit less intensity. So I've got that up there, and I think it looks good. Now, to get it to apply, this is a good hint. Whenever you guys are trying to add a bit of light to an image, you can use something called apply image, which just basically puts on your layer mask. It makes the darks a little bit darker on your layer mask, and it just has the light not show up where the darks are. So it continues to lighten your highlights, and it kind of ignores the shadows. It just makes everything blend a lot better. So what we're going to do is I'm going to go up here to image, down here to apply image. And you would do this right here on your layer mask. So this is what my layer mask looks like before, okay? We're going to go to image, down here to apply image, and let's go over here, and you can see already taking effect. So there's the preview. There's the before and the after. You can see it just looks quite a bit more natural. Okay, and what you want to do is choose merged, RGB, multiply, opacity 100, and you're good to go. So this is what my layer mask looks like now. It just kind of takes a snapshot of our image. Wherever's darker doesn't show up, and wherever's lighter does show up, which is perfect for, you know, adding some highlights. If you want to go a little bit more, make it subtle, just do it again. Image, down here to apply image, and you can see it's going to be a little bit more subtle now. Okay, and you can decide how bright or how dark you want this. It's totally up to you. Now, I'm going to do the same thing again, just because I do want to brighten the dress up, but I want it to be a little bit not as bright. So we're going to grab our curves adjustment layer again. Let's brighten that up right about there. I'm going to hit Command I, and here on our dress, there we go. We're going to paint this in as well. And then I'm going to go to image and down here to apply image. And let's just do that again. There we go. And we can kind of see there's a little bit of overlap here. So if I want to just, this is what my layer mask looks like now. It's just, you know, it goes from being just a white blob to something with a lot of detail, which is very cool. Generally, I don't like to destroy the detail that's in there. Like if I take it and I just start painting black now, what happens is I destroy all the detail that's there. So generally what I do instead of just painting black on this layer mask, I will group this layer with itself. So I'm going to hit Command G, group that layer with itself, and then I can put a layer mask on that group. Then I can start to fade some things away if I want them, and I don't have to worry about affecting this because I am affecting this instead. All right. Thanks, Creative Life. They're tweeting at me here. So we can affect the layer mask on the group instead of the actual layer mask on the layer, and that's just going to help me blend everything just a little bit better. All right, very cool. And we'll just grab one final effect. I'm going to just put a little bit of light and a little bit of color on this because when you add light sources, I think it's a good time, and I think it's a little bit of fun just to add a little color. So we're going to bring up our RGB, but I'm also going to grab our blues, and I'm going to pull that up a little bit, and then I'm going to grab our greens, and I'm going to pull that up a little bit as well. So maybe the light that's coming out of her head is got a little bit of color into it too. So it's not just, not just a white light. It's going to have a little bit of color. There we go. And we can just kind of paint around and imitate a bright glow there. Very cool. So you can see it just kind of adds that little bit of color, and maybe put a little bit in her dress there. We can even do image down here to apply image. Yeah, you know what? I don't even like that. I think it looked better before. So there we go, adding that little bit of a light glow. So you guys can see that really didn't take too long. I don't know if this would have any effect or, any application on any of your images, but if it does, this is a really cool way to make a shape with light and then kind of have it affect the rest of your image. So guys, thanks so much for watching this tutorial. I hope you really loved it. Find a lot more here at phlearn.com. We've got like over 450 videos for free. So that's a lot, and it should take up quite a bit of your life watching them. It's taken up quite a bit of mine making them. Thanks guys. I'll phlearn you later. Bye everyone. I'm pretty sure you can get away with anything when you have a helium voice.
Kitty sprinkles.
Your breath
tastes like a dog's butt.
A whale's vagina.
I don't like your mother's cooking.
I'm not wearing any pants right now.